kid, I just loved playing hide and seek, lock and key, running, running, lagori, and so on. We loved to go out and shout and yell our lungs out. But today's generation, kids, don't seem to love playing outside. They are very happy playing all indoor games for various reasons. And one important reason is the video game. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests, the invasion of the video games has changed the lives of our kids. The most common positive impact stated by many is that these video games improve the manual dexterity and computer literacy of the child. The child improves his hand and eye coordination. He learns to solve problems quickly. He can think logically, take quick decisions, and so on. There are many games where the parent and the child play together, and it is a very good bonding activity. But mind you, there is a flip side. Some of these games are really violent, and playing these violent video games can be more harmful than watching a violent movie or a violent TV program. And there are reasons for it. First, a violent video game is active. Watching a TV is passive. For example, and we learn a lot by actively getting involved in something. For example, if we have to learn to fly an airplane, what would we do? Will we read a book, watch a TV program, or use a flight simulator? Definitely a flight simulator. Second, a video game played by a player makes a player identify himself with the negative character, the violent character. If the game is a first player and he's a shooter, he starts having a visual perspective of a killer and he loves killing. It evokes a lot of violent feeling in him. And if it is a third person game, he still controls the activity of the killer. So this way, he becomes more aggressive. Third point, these violent games also reward points. If you kill your enemy, you get some points or you go to the next level. And we all know, by rewarding the behavior frequency is going to only increase. The next point, a child can get confused between reality and fantasy. The next point that I would like to emphasize is a child, when allowed to play for a long time, loses track of time. He sits and plays for a very long, long time, and there is a chance of health hazards like child obesity. Now, my only request is the parents or grandparents or people who have children at home, please do encourage children to play video games, but also look into what game they are playing. You can also take some time out, discuss with the child and fix a time limit so that they don't while away the time and get into all these negative aspects. One last thing. If you come across information about the negativity of the game, please do share it with other parents so that it will help them in good parenting. With this, I would like to conclude that appreciate your child in whatever they do, encourage them in whatever they do, but please also see to it that they don't get into an aggressive mode. Thank you.